tell us a bit about how you came into politics, because you had a very successful corporate career. To give that up, is that because your Yashwant Sinha's son in politics is in your blood and it came naturally to you?
There's a legacy of service in my family. Of course, it's not just my father who's been in politics for 30 years, but it's also many other members of my family that have been in the civil services. My brother-in-law is in the Indian Foreign Service. He's India's ambassador to Beijing right now. So everybody in my family is incredibly patriotic and incredibly committed to India. And so I've always wanted at some point to be able to come and give back to the country what I can. And so when the opportunity presented itself to be of service to the country and to be of service to all citizens, including you, Rahul, and everybody else in this room, I took it with both hands.
You know, you, as things would have it, your father currently, on several issues, is at odds with the Modi government. Does that make life tricky for you as a junior minister in the Modi government when your father is constantly speaking against him or taking pot shots? Does that make it, Papa ji, kyun bol diya, ye to problem ho gayi?
My father is a very wise man. He has a lot of very important inputs to provide to all of us. I take his advice very, very seriously. He, I think, is being very, very thoughtful and constructive in the
manner. Has anyone in government ever told you, please speak to dad and see if he stops criticizing us, it'll be nice?
No, we have a very open and responsive government. We get advice and inputs from many, many people, many wise people, and we take them all on board so that we can serve all of you better.